Given the function f of x equals 1 divided by the quantity x minus 2 plus 1, we want to determine the domain of the function, then complete the table of values and graph the function. The domain is a set of all possible inputs or x values for the function. And when dealing with rational functions, it's easier to find the x values that we must exclude from the domain. And we can do this by remembering that division by 0 is undefined. And since this fraction bar here represents division, we need to exclude the values of x that make this denominator equal to 0. Notice if x is equal to 2, the denominator here would be 0, which means 2 cannot be in the domain of this function, but all of the real values can be. So the domain is all real numbers, or all reals, except x equals 2. This is also helpful in a couple other ways. First, as long as the 0 of the denominator is not also a 0 of the numerator, we will have a vertical asymptote at x equals 2, which is a vertical line that the graph will approach. So we'll have a vertical asymptote here, which will be helpful when sketching the graph. Next, we're also going to put x equals 2 right in the middle of the table of values, as we see here. So when x equals 2, the function, or y, is undefined. The reason we want it to be in the middle is we now want to select values of x that are greater than 2 and x values that are less than 2. And it's always helpful to select an x value that's just a little bit greater than 2. For example, here we selected 2.25 and then increasing values of x. And then for a value that's just less than 2, we selected 1.75 and then decreasing values of x. Now we'll complete this table by performing substitution into our function. So when x is equal to 4, notice how the denominator would be 2. So we'd have 1 half plus 1, which would be 1.5 or 1.5. When x is equal to 3, notice the denominator here would just be 1. 1 over 1 is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. When x is equal to 2.5, notice how the denominator would be 0.5. So we'd have y equals 1 divided by 0.5 plus 1. 0.5 is equal to 1 half. Dividing by 1 half is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So we can write this as 1 times 2 over 1 or 2 plus 1. That'd be 2 plus 1 or 3. When x is 2.25, notice the denominator here would just be 0.25. So we'd have y equals 1 divided by 0.25 plus 1. Well, 0.25 is equal to 1/4. This is 1 divided by 1/4, or 1 times the reciprocal of 4 plus 1. 1 times 4 is 4, plus 1 is 5. And now when x is 1.75, notice how the denominator would be negative 0.25. So we'd have y equals 1 divided by negative 0.25 plus 1. This would be 1 divided by negative 1/4, or 1 times negative 4 plus 1. Be negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3. When x is equal to 1.5, notice the denominator would be negative 0.5. So we'd have 1 divided by negative 0.5 plus 1. This is 1 divided by negative 1/2, or 1 times the reciprocal, which is negative 2 plus 1. This would be negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1. And of course, we can always verify these on the calculator. When x is equal to 1, notice the denominator is going to be negative 1. 1 divided by negative 1 is negative 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. And then when x is 0, this would just be negative 1/2 plus 1, which would be positive 1/2. So as you can see, for a rational function, sometimes completing this table can be a little bit more challenging, but again, we can always verify this with a calculator if needed. Let's go ahead and plot these points and see if we can sketch our graph. So we have 4, 1.5, that's going to be here. 3, 2, be here. 2.53 be here. 2.255, so as we get closer and closer to this vertical asymptote, y starts increasing faster, maybe somewhere in here. And then we have 1.75, negative 3, that'd be somewhere in here. 1.5, negative 1 is here. 1, 0 is here. And 0, 1 half is here. There's one more thing we should probably consider before sketching our graph. We know it's going to approach this vertical asymptote, but if we look at this function and see how it behaves as x approaches positive infinity or gets larger and larger, notice how this fraction here would approach 0, so we'd be approaching the value of 0 plus 1 or y equals 1. This is telling us that we're going to have a vertical asymptote at y equals 1. Notice as we move to the left or approach negative infinity, this fraction here is still going to approach 0. And 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, which verifies we have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1. That's important because we know the graph is also going to approach the horizontal asymptote as well as the vertical asymptote. So this piece of the graph would look something like this. And this piece would look something like this. Now there's one more thing that we can say about this function since we've already studied transformations. It's a little harder to see transformations when dealing with rational functions. But if we let the basic rational function y equals 1 over x equal f of x, and call this function g of x, we could say that g of x is equal to f of the quantity x minus 2 plus 1, which means the red graph has been shifted up 1 unit and right 2 units to create the blue function. Again, it's been shifted up 1 unit and right 2 units. So again, it is harder to see this when dealing with rational functions because there's more than one piece, but it is another way to graph these types of functions. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next few videos.